bodies. Could they be from Moonlight Town? Whoa, did puppets do this?
Do you want to go up, child? I'm sorry, but the train isn't in service anymore. The cathedral isn't the sanctuary it once was. The people who went up there never returned. I still don't know what happened, but I do know this. The cathedral is off limits, forever. If you're determined to pass, you must prove your identity. Who are you? Are you a stalker? Interesting. I thought all the stalkers died when the workshop tower collapsed. As for me, I'm as good as dead. A sinner who lost everyone I ever loved. I have no right to stop someone as determined as you. Please be safe up there.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome aboard the Pilgrim's Cable Railway. Now, those of you who joined us in Moonlight Town, we hope your preparations for the Pilgrim's Journey are well underway. Fascinating town, Moonlight, just fascinating. Back in the day, the only way to reach the cathedral was using a rope and pulley. So, thanks for building it on a cliff, St. Frangelico. I kid, Frangelica, wonderful saint, wonderful. Anyway, next stop, the Bridge of Atonement. While you atone there, don't miss a magnificent view of the beautiful Crot. It's been my pleasure, friends, and enjoy the rest of your journey. I've been your captain on this ride, Gemini! Well, not bad, huh?
Oh, I really am good at this.
When in doubt, let Gemini be your guide. You look annoyed. What I do? I'm sure it's fine. Let's get a move on, pal. Oh, something's off. Do you see that over there? I recognize dead puppets. That's to be expected, but what is that? No idea what those things are, pal. Approach with caution.
Thank you.
is happening? What's their problem? Wait. Wait, their bodies are strangely altered. I don't know what's going on, but keep those eyes of yours open.
Mercy, I beg you, don't kill me. I thought you were from the organization. Never mind. My name is Janjo. I'm an pharmacist. Yes, pharmacist. I'm looking for the legendary gold coin fruit. I was able to use medicine to slow the infection spread. I have the petrification disease, and I need a cure. Sorry, I ramble when I'm nervous. Read this. It'll explain things faster than I can. Many substances can be poisonous. The precise dose is what separates medicine from poison. The gold coin fruit might just be a myth, but in the midst of an epidemic, it might be our salvation. Can you let me know if you find it? I'll give you this by way of payment. The people of ancient Krat knew how to bottle a wish upon a star. They claimed special powers after distilling the wish into a cube made from a meteorite. I don't know how it works, but it's said to react to someone who has ergo and grant them power. If you can help me with the gold coin tree, I'll give you more of this. Seems there's a new threat every day, friend. And no safe place in the world. No place to just take a breath. I'm headed to the St. Frangelico Cathedral. Perhaps find some peace there. If you find the gold coin tree, please find me there. The people of ancient Krat knew how to bottle a wish upon a star. They claimed special powers after distilling the wish into a cube made from a meteorite. I don't know how it works, but it's said to react to someone who has ergo and grant them power. You ever wish upon a star, Stalker? I hope this wishstone helps you with that.
the humans. So says the king.
Andreas once told me. Always be true to myself. I'm surprised to see who's... well, alive. Oh, where are my manners? I'm Cecile, and I serve the Archbishop. I'm the only one left. Everyone's dead. From the petrification disease, or from the monsters. I didn't die. But my heart breaks more each day. Can you do me a kindness? Bring me the holy mark from the Archbishop's quarters. The Archbishop was a true saint. He was my savior. If I write his words into my heart, maybe it'll give me the strength to carry on. I can't die. But perhaps this can help me live again. Please, bring me the holy mark as quickly as you can. I can't die. But perhaps this can help me live again. Please, bring me the holy mark as quickly as you can. I can't die. But perhaps this can help me live again. Please, bring me the holy mark as quickly as you can.
damn it. I can't find the way out. Monsters everywhere. I need to grab my share and leave. I thought I was the only one with a sound mind here. Sure, I don't need to introduce myself. Note these golden wings. Yes, you guessed it. You don't know who I am. Preposterous! Everyone in Krat has heard of me. Do you live under a rock? I'm Alidoro the Hound. Treasure hunter extraordinaire. Yes, yes, it's a nickname. I ditched my real name in the past. I'm looking for other survivors of this disaster, but it's been a lonely search, and there's danger around every corner. Do you know of a place where I can take refuge? Preferably someplace clean and comfortable, you know, civilized. Vernini Works? I didn't give that place much thought. That's where the puppets are being made, after all. But I heard tell of a shelter there as well. With no first-hand knowledge, I suppose I have to trust you. I have a lot of searching ahead of me, so why don't I lighten my load? Consider this an act of charity. A thank you gift. Take it. Since you're so helpful, I'll give you... As a descendant of aristocrats, the very best families, I have a duty to the common people. I live my life fulfilling that duty. And part of that duty is ensuring these items are returned to their rightful owners. What I'm showing you is just a portion of the collection. If you come to the refuge, we'll be able to continue our confabulation. Until then, remember this hound when golden wings shine.
Oh, thank you. Just seeing the Archbishop's holy mark renews my spirit. It's a reminder of the quiet power of faith. I'll remember this forever, Stalker. It's a reminder of the quiet power.
Thank you. And now, the stage is set.
Before the green overtook me.
Name happened here. Oh, I haven't a clue myself. There's got to be someone at the hotel who knows something.
Once, Krat was just a small town on the coast of little importance. Before Elysian Boulevard was built, this place literally was all there was of Krat. But when some in the city prospered, they left the old town behind. Through isolation and neglect, Krat's first incarnation became nothing but dangerous alleys and desperate slums. On the bright side, I guess, the whole city of Krat's pretty much like that now. The old town caught up with the new. It's true what they say. A receding tide sinks all boats.
Thank you. Maybe those who went there seeking refuge became monsters somehow. But the petrification disease turns you to stone, not into a monster. I'm worried about the Malam district, just below the cathedral. I wonder whether there are monsters there, too.
Petrification disease turned into a monster. That's just tragic. Could the disease lead to puppet frenzy? No, that doesn't make sense. Remember, puppets cannot get the disease. But puppets shouldn't frenzy either. I made them to obey and protect humans, not go berserk and harm them. But the Stalkers blame me. They think I worked with the alchemists to spread the disease to puppets. How sad. All this resentment, with a lie at the root of it. That's why my only wish is that you stay a good boy. No resentment, no lies. The city of Krat. Ask me any.
Never meet again. Can't say I'm happy to see you, though. Sorry, I let my frustration get the better of me. This place is crawling with hostile puppets. You must have known that, but you still sent me here. Honor and trust are everything to this hound. You've insulted me to the core. I'll never forgive you. But perhaps there's a shred of decency in you? So I'll ask again. Do you know of a safe place? Nice try, but I've been there already and I know better. The puppets have already destroyed that place. Again, you spurn my trust. But even a brave soul like me cannot afford another enemy in times like these. I shall show you mercy. Perhaps it will inspire a nobler spirit in you. But beware. Do not fool me ever again. You tricked me with your lie. You disappoint me. But I'm no stranger to beneficence, so I shall let it pass one more time. Know that even my forgiveness has its limits. Remember, the hound's fangs crave the traitor's neck. You tricked me with your lie. But I'm no stranger to beneficence. Remember, it seems the hotel is the only other option. You. This hotel is indeed a refuge from the dangers of the outside world. I am the Hound, a descendant of the city's most aristocratic families. Repaying debts is what we nobles do. Betrayal creates a debt that is particularly hard to pay back. But I am a man with generosity and mercy in abundance. I shall give you the honor of viewing my treasure so that you may apologize. However, you must prove your worthiness. For this legendary treasure, the ego of a powerful enemy shall suffice. It's up to you if you want to make the exchange. Take your time to admire it. I've certainly done likewise. A great weapon calls for a great...
of Anini, even... Oh dear. This is the mark of the Black Rabbit Brotherhood, a notorious band of stalkers. The stalkers as a unified force ceased to be after their defeat at the Battle of the Workshop Tower. The Black Rabbit Brotherhood took over the Marlam district after that. I believe you could use this mark to move safely whilst on the Black Rabbit Brotherhood's turf, to use their unsophisticated vernacular, and give you entree to the black market as well. But be careful, sir. The Black Rabbit Brotherhood is quite infamous for how they treat interlopers. If they catch you, they'll put you in the liar's coffin. Yes, I believe it is as unpleasant as it sounds. Ah, and I see we have new physical records to catalogue for the collection. Such effort deserves commensurate reward, don't you think?
Then my eyes do not deceive me. I never imagined I'd actually see it again, and in the flesh, so to speak. I just designed it, set it aside, and never got back to it. Genius and acclaim can keep one quite preoccupied, I'm afraid. You are really interested in the arm, I see. Then, my friend, you shall have it. It just needs a few mechanical adjustments to fit your, particular needs. And frankly, this design is almost child's play to me now, so let's start by making it a bit stronger, shall we? I will also add what we brilliant inventors call modularity. That means it will be much easier to improve and repair since you'll be able to use commonly found parts. You might say this arm's new abilities are... Legion! No? Too much? It was too much. I've been investigating the puppet frenzy, and it looks like I need your help. First, let me show you a little something I've been working on. I call it the Ergo Wavelength Decoder. The name lacks a certain flair, but I assure you it works. If my suspicions are correct, something in the puppet's very ergo is causing their aggression. My decoder can find malicious signals within the waves, but I cannot possibly get close enough to gather the ergo wave records myself. You, on the other hand, would you? Could you? I refuse to believe the King of Puppets is truly behind this puppet rampage. It's too simple, but also a bit too much even for him. No. I suspect the ergo itself is corrupted, or at least compromised. I do so desperately want to find the cause, as I'm sure you do too, my friend. It breaks my heart to see puppets turned into murderous tools of bloodshed. Isn't this a cryptic vessel? Well, I would expect nothing less from you. What I mean, of course, is that this is a humble invention of mine. A cipher device. Once your information is locked in here, only you can get it out. Of course, once people realize the value of a truly unbreakable way to keep secrets, knockoffs flood the market. The trials and travails of true genius, forever copied, never credited. But, I admit, even some of these knockoffs could still hold secrets. You're welcome to take a crack at, cracking it. Who knows? It could lead you to something truly valuable, or at least more practical. May I be of assistance? I can decipher this in moments, if you'd allow me. I admit I'm a bit rusty, but it's all starting to come back to me. Genius never sleeps and never truly abandons the truly brilliant. What? No, of course I didn't read the contents. Who has time to read anymore? But I could help you read it if you want to. I always welcome friends. May I? No one, not even I, know what started the puppet frenzy. Why? That day of all days... it was horrible. A violent rampage of murder and mayhem that is seared into my memory for all time. And it was never supposed to happen again. I made sure of it. Designed a few special parts to ensure they'd remain loyal. Puppet armies do not arise by chance. There was intent behind this. I don't want to leap to conclusions, but the only one I know with that kind of power is the King of Puppets himself. We need to learn how this happened.